Hello everyone, welcome to computer classes, and in this video we will make few programs based on Fournier's law. About Fournier's law we have already discussed in the previous video, and you can get the link of that video in the description box. So let's start. First program is write a program to display first 10 terms of the series. What is the series? 3, 6, 12, 24. Now first we will see what is this series. 3, 6, 12 means 3 into 2, 6. 6 into 2, 12. 12 into 2, 24. Fine. These terms are getting multiplied by 2. Fine. So let's start. By using Fournier's we are making these programs. CLS. Let's start with CLS. Then 4. I equals to, first we will see how many terms we need to display. So we need to display how many terms? 10 terms. So loop will go I equals to 1 to 10. Fine. Now which terms are there? 3, 6, 12. So we need to take a variable in which we assign these values. So that variable I am taking n equals to 3. So we will take a variable and initialize that variable with the first value. Whatever the first value is, we will always take a variable and initialize it with first value. In this case it is 3, so n equals to 3 always. Fine. In such type of questions always we will do the same procedure. For I equals to 1 to 10. How many terms? 10. So I will write 1 to 10. Now we need to display what? Simple. We need to display n only. These terms, these are n. So print n. I will write print n. So it will display 3. So how it will display the next value? So how will you get the next value? By multiplying this term with 2. Again, by multiplying this 6 with 2, you will get the next. So, how will you get the next value? N equals to N into 2. Initially, N is 3. So, print 3. 3 will be displayed. Then, how will you get the next value? 3 into 2, 6. Fine. Then, I will close it next time. So again it will transfer the control here. Step will be 2i 2 print n. So n, what was the n this time? 6. Fine. 6 into 2, 12. Again it will go, 12 will be displaced. 12 into 2, 24. 24 again, 24 will be displayed. 24 into 2, 48. So these two statements will be repeated how many times? 10 times. So it will display you 3, 6, 12, 24, 48 and so on. So on means up to 10th term, not infinite. Fine. Because it will go to up to the 10 only. As the value of I exceeds 10, it will come out and it will end the program. That's it. Fine. Okay, let's take more programs, more series. Now if the next series is, instead of this I am taking another series, and series is minus 1, 2, 5, 8 and so on. This is a series, minus 1, 2, 5, 8 and so on. You need to display again first 10 terms. So what changes shall I do in this program? N equals to, I said value of n will always be the first term of the series, whatever it is. So in this case minus 1, so I will write n equals to minus 1. Fine. Now for loop will go up to how many terms? In this case also 10 terms. If it is asked 15 terms, then you need to write over here 1 to 15, but again 10, so we will write 10 only. Print n, so minus 1 will be displayed. Now how will you get the next number? Minus 1 plus 3 equals to 2, 2 plus 3 equals to 5, 5 plus 3 equals to 8, so it means we will add 3. Fine. So what changes shall I do? N equals to n plus 3. Fine. Minus 2 plus 3. Sorry, minus 1 plus 3, you will get 2. Next time, 2 plus 3, you will get 5. 5 plus 3, you will get 8. And it will keep on displaying. 10 times it will move, it will go. And when it exits, it will come out and end the program. Fine. Now, if in the same program, I ask you not to display first 10 term, I need sum of first 10 terms of the series. In the same program, I will make changes. So I am making changes over here. Write a program to display sum of first 10 terms of the series. Fine. Of the same series, let it be. N equals to minus 1 will be same. Now we will not display N. We will not display N. I don't need this. Fine. And one more thing, I need sum. So to calculate sum, which variable we take? Accumulator variable. So I'm writing one more variable. I'm taking one more variable, s equals to 0. Fine. And we will calculate the sum. How I will calculate the sum? S equals to s plus n. So in s, it will accumulate all the values of n. It will keep on adding values of n. Minus 1 plus 2 plus 5 plus 8 up to 10 terms. Fine. And what is first? See, n equals to minus. Initially it is minus 1. So s is 0, 0 plus minus 1, minus 1. S will be minus 1. Then n equals to n plus 3. Minus 1 plus 3, 2. Again it will come here. S was initially minus 1. So minus 1 plus 2. Minus 1 plus 2 will be 1. Fine. So this will be S. Again, 2 plus 3, 5. S was 1. 5 plus 1, 6. So it will keep on adding. S equals to S plus 1, N will keep on adding. Minus 1 plus 2 plus 5 plus 8 and so on. And it will keep on increasing the value of n. First one was minus 1 and the next is 2 and the next is 5. Fine. Now when it comes out after completing the 10 iterations, when it comes out, we will display sum. Print sum equals to s. That's it. And always remember, in every loop there are three things: initialization, condition, I should be less than equals to 10, and the increment through step. Why I have not written step here? Because it is continuous loop. Continuous loop means increment is of 1. Fine. 1 2 3 4 5 6, I is increasing like this. That's why. And next I will return the control back to the step. Fine. Okay. Now one more series I am taking to make it more clear. I am taking the series 7, 14, 21, 28 and so on. Let it be first, we will calculate the sum. Sum of first 10 terms of the series 7, 14, 21, 28. So in this case, what changes shall I do? S equals to 0 will be here. CLS you can write, fine. CLS S equals to 0, fine. N equals to first term of the series. So in this case it is 7. How many terms? Okay, I am making it, suppose it is 7 terms, suppose. Fine. So loop will go up to 7. Fine. S equals to S plus N. Fine. We need to find the sum of these terms only. And how will you get the next value of N? Earlier it was 7. Now it is 14. Second term is 14. Then 21. So difference is of 7. Fine. This you need to see only. So instead of N equals to N plus 3, what shall I write? N equals to N plus 7. Fine. So it will display the sum of first 7 terms, because I have taken here 7. It can be 15, it can be 20. Fine. I have taken 7. So it will display the sum of first 7 terms of this series. And when it come out, it will display sum equals to S and then end. Fine. Now, if I ask you to display first 7 terms, so we will remove S from here and simply we will write print N. Instead of S equals to S plus N, we will write print N and we will remove this print sum. That's it. Fine. So I hope these programs are clear. Thank you so much.